Well, we've got the Telegraph again, and if you ever get arrested, try to put on an accent. Apparently the courts will go easy on you. Not a problem for you, Nicholas.
No, I can't. I've been accused of, on a good day, I look Italian with a weird accent. But I can, you know, dial up the different accents as well.
You do Scottish. But,
I wouldn't dare in front of you. Foreign criminals will serve shorter sentences than Britons under emergency plan. This is a fascinating story and also gets a bit philosophical. Essentially, we are, again, short on prison spots as well. And, you know, I want to blame immigration, but it's true. you know, because a lot of the prison population is also composed of foreigners.
Well, and 10,500 apparently are foreign nationals.
Exactly.
In the UK.
And this early removal scheme was already in place. Essentially, if you're a foreigner, before finishing your term, it used to be 12 months. Now the Justice Ministry has extended that or wants to extend that to 18 months. You can basically released from prison and deported to your country of origin, where you wouldn't necessarily serve the rest of the term. And this is, of course, to curb the problem of prison overpopulation.
Yeah.
Now, it is controversial, has been criticized by the Lords Secondary Legislation Scrutiny Committee, because, one, essentially it means two people, Briton and foreigner, doing the same crime, one of them obviously is released earlier.
Yeah.
And secondly, it might work as a, you know, as an incentive for foreigners to say, okay, I might not, you know, serve the whole sentence. So these are the controversial aspects of the
and we've seen in the past some judges give more lenient sentences to foreign nationals,
yeah, already,
for sexual crimes, because they say, well, look, this guy's come from, you know, whatever country where they don't have the same sexual morality and sexual
in your
laws.
Culture, it's okay to sexually harass people,
yes,
or whatever.
It's unfair to punish him according to UK law.
Unfair. Brilliant. I mean, when I first read this, I thought, well, yeah, why would we want to pay for at least £47,000 a year to keep someone in prison? That's just amazing. But anyway,
we could send them to Centre Parks for
I was thinking exactly that thought. Where could I stay for 47 grand a year? Anyway, so my first thought was, why would we want to pay for that? Send them home.
That's the argument for it, yeah.
Right. Well, yeah. But it's, I mean, that's just not, as you say, it's not philosophically sound. And it also just doesn't work, does it? Because if you're creating a place where you're a soft touch, then somebody could decide they're going to leave anyway and then just commit a crime and have a free ticket.
So we're creating crime tourism.
But they will
going to come to the UK.
To be fair to the Department of Justice, they will serve their sentence up to 18 months before the release date.
Right.
And then again, considering that everybody wants to come to Britain, apparently, being deported from Britain is also punishment enough,
but
in a way.
We're not always that good at
from
deporting,
a patriotic point
of
view.
Do you think they would get deported?
Well, as long as that's the idea. But then if it doesn't happen,